Good afternoon, respectful media people. I'm a vice consul from Russian Federation in Chennai, but also I'm a representative of Russian governmental state agency Россотрудничество. This federal agency is acting under the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and is responsible for humanitarian cooperation. For that purpose, we have Russian centers of science and culture all over the world in 90 countries, and five of them we have in India, in Delhi, Mumbai, Calcutta, Chennai, and Trivandrum. And I would say our main competence here is educational cooperation. We engaged into other humanitarian activities. We teach Russian language. We organize different events about Russian culture, but education is a key field of cooperation in humanitarian field between Russia and India, and we're very happy to have a reliable long-term partner, study abroad company that is more than 20 years, is helping us to provide opportunities, educational opportunities for young Indian people all over India, in particular in South India. Annually, we have this exhibition fair in which we try to call representatives of leading Russian universities. Nowadays, we can witness that the amount of those who want to study in Russia is growing. In our consulate district, in educational year 2016-2017, we gave 800 visas, and in educational year 17-18, we issued 1,230 plus visas. And by now, the most popular is medical education. Very much like that, Indian people go to receive high quality medical education in Russian Federation. We actually very seriously taking them and seriously controlling their performance to be sure that coming back here they would really be good doctors. But also we would like to increase the amount of engineering students, and especially in that fields of cooperation in which our countries have intensive bilateral relationship. So when our leaders, newly elected president of Russian Federation Vladimir Putin and his Indian colleague Prime Minister Narendra Modi meet, they always discuss that there is insufficient amount of high quality human resource to participate in joint projects such as nuclear engineering, military engineering, space. All that ambitious projects demands a lot of quality specialists. For example, each unit of nuclear power plant demands at least 1,000 of quality human resources. And apart from commercial education that we are suggesting, we are also distributing governmental scholarships that are paid by from the budget of Russian Federation by Russian taxpayers. And for the last years, we are working hard on increasing the amount of foreign students generally. Our Minister of Education has ambitious plans of increasing the amount of foreign students up to 750,000 by the year 2025. And for that purpose, universities are receiving sufficient funding from government, but also a strict control that they are meeting demands of and provide high quality service, let us say, customers. Coming back to that governmental scholarships that we are distributing this year, we have around 100 scholarships, and apart from that, universities have their own quotas for this scholarship. There is one website, russia.study, that provides full information about this scholarship. This year the system is generally that people can come and apply for any type of specialty and choose any university to go and to study for free in Russian Federation, but the choice will be made by a very serious commission that include His Excellency Ambassador of Russian Federation in India, representative of my organization Россотрудничество, representative of Ministry of Foreign Affairs, representative of Ministry of Education, and jointly they decide and choose people basing on their academic performance mostly. So there is a transparent system when they apply for scholarship, and they also apart from the application form that they are uploading on the russia.study website, they also uploading additional information such as mass media, public magazine publications, and their research scientific works. So all of that is calculated to generally appreciate capacity of a potential scholarship student. So by now the program is practically over, but still somebody, some people I think still have chance to apply for that. It's depending on speciality, but this opportunity still exists, I think, till the 1st of June. If they are fast enough, they can still apply for this academic year, but generally, of course, they can apply for the next. As we planning this work for many years ahead. So that is mostly key points of educational cooperation between our two countries. I would just would like to ask you to provide correct information and spread this information about Indian young people so that they realize the opportunities to go and receive high quality education. Russia is a very friendly country to India, and we can say that Indian students in Russia showing best performance. The amount of Indian students, this is the second largest group of students if we don't take countries of former USSR. So we have already, we can say that we have a many years tradition of Indian students studying in Russia. Already some universities start to have a cricket team and more opportunities in terms of vegetarian food available in university canteens. So generally we also try to follow the destiny of these people after they are coming back to India, and we can say that most of the people that receive education in Russian Federation gain success after coming back and having successful career and life generally here in India. So our universities are open, our heart is open for Indian people and Indian-Russian friendship. Thank you.